Hi, I'm Jen. I've been an analyst for over 15 years, and today I'm looking at data analyst reality versus expectations. They can sometimes be quite a bit different. Let's get right into them. The first expectation that people have is you'll be solving very complex mathematical or statistical problems all the time. In some ways, maybe Dr. Sheldon Cooper is your peer in the organization. The reality, though, is for most analyst jobs, math is one of the smallest pieces of the work. You definitely need those skills. They come in handy. More so than the actual statistical skills, the process skills and the way of analyzing a problem. Think about writing proofs and the skills that are required where you take things that you know to explain something you don't know. These are skills you definitely need. Before you can even get to those math skills, you often have to use a lot of communication skills to understand the problem. You'll use a lot of time organizing data, putting it together, making it make sense. And then you'll do a little math, and then you'll do more time visualizing and explaining it. If you can't explain all of that math that you did, nobody's gonna care even a little bit. The second expectation most people have about analysts is they're working on these really massive, groundbreaking, forward-thinking, innovative solutions to problems. The reality is, you will, occasionally, maybe sometimes. But in between, there's a lot of the day-to-day slog. There's a lot of work that needs to be done to keep the business running. There's a lot that tends to be more reporting. Regardless of what type of analytics job you have, there's going to be a lot of it that's really retroactive looking, that's analyzing past history, that's maybe less innovative than what other people might expect it to be. The third common myth or expectation is that you need to know a lot about IT to be an analyst or a data scientist. Whether this is programming skills or a lot of technical computer system skills, a lot of people expect that that's something that you have to have to get into analytics. The reality is, the majority of jobs that are in analytics don't have that much programming. They have a little bit of it. You should learn programming. That is going to make you a much stronger candidate. But the reality is, most people don't have IT degrees when they're getting into data analytics or data science. And some analytics jobs don't require any programming skills whatsoever. Jobs like data reporting analyst, where you are working with data, but you're not doing programming, you're really doing more reporting, organizing, categorizing data. The last expectation that we'll talk about today is that you're going to love working in analytics. The reality is, you'll probably love working in analytics. I think analytics is a blast. It takes a certain personality, a certain skill set to really enjoy it. And there are people that don't, and there's always going to be jobs that aren't as fun as others, or bosses or organizations that just aren't that pleasant to work for. But analytics can be a ton of fun. I love that everything is a little bit different each day. And I love that you're solving problems, you're figuring out answers that really are going to help people, help the business. And you did that. You're doing something really unique that takes a special talent and skill set. So even if there's going to be some tough days and some things that aren't as pleasant, data analytics really is a fun field to work in that's incredibly rewarding. Did you like hearing about the expectations versus the reality of being a data analyst or data scientist? Let me know by giving this video a thumbs up or leaving a comment. If you want me to break down more assumptions about analytics or data analysts, let me know those assumptions in the comments. I'd be happy to address them. Thanks so much for watching.